on the town. In sono giunta d'ora, forse da un po' di già.
Impossible to convey a just idea of the agony which this disease can inflict. In general, people are apt to relegate such inconceivable sufferings to the category of the incredible. Any mention of them in conversation or in writing is considered in the light of current beliefs, the individual's personal beliefs in particular, and tends to provoke a smile of incredulity and derision. The reason for this incomprehension is that mankind has not yet discovered a cure for this disease. Relief from it is to be found only in the oblivion brought about by wine and in the artificial sleep induced by opium and similar narcotics. Alas, the effects of such medicines are only temporary. After a certain point, instead of alleviating the pain, they only intensify it. Will anyone ever penetrate the secret of this disease which transcends ordinary experience? This reverberation of the shadow of the mind, which manifests itself in a state of coma, like that between death and resurrection, when one is neither asleep nor awake. My one fear is that tomorrow I may die without having come to know myself. In the course of my life, I have discovered that a fearful abyss lies between me and other people, and have realized that my best course is to remain silent and keep my thoughts to myself for as long as I can. I have now made up my mind to write, it is only in order to reveal myself to my shadow. That shadow which at this moment is stretched across the wall in the attitude of one devouring with insatiable appetite each word I write. It is for his sake that I wish to make the attempt. Who knows, we may perhaps come to know each other better. Ever since I broke the last ties which held me to the rest of mankind, my one desire has been to attain a better knowledge of myself. Idle thoughts, perhaps, yet they torment me more savagely than any reality could do. Do not the rest of mankind who look like me, who appear to have the same needs and the same passions as I, exist only in order to cheat me? Are they not a mere handful of shadows which have come into existence only that they may mock and cheat me? Is not everything that I feel, see, and think something entirely imaginary, something utterly different from reality? I am writing only for my shadow, which is now stretched across the wall in the light of the lamp. Who knows, we may perhaps come to know each other better.